All right, so yeah, we were going to leave here and then head up to. We're on, by the way, and we were going to head up to parents' house. So let me set this up here. Let's see. Let's go to here. Kind of C3 are here.
I'm assuming we got directions to the parents' house, right?
Looked them up in the phone book.
The Halfling Hills Digest.
Exactly.
The Gazette. The
The Facebook group for Halfling Hills.
Gazette. No, the
Next door,
next door,
Halfling.
next door. Have yes. What day is garbage day? Did someone hear those gunshots? I saw a coyote in my backyard.
Khalil, I think those were fireworks.
In my neighborhood.
All
I'm in
right.
the country.
The what?
I'm in the country.
Oh, I thought you said I'm in The Conjuring. I'm like, ooh, that's not a good thing.
Oh. No, I'm in the country, and
That
so
could be
yeah.
worse.
It's a 50-50 on whether it's gunshots or fireworks.
All right, so yeah, we're making our way back north. We've left the city, we've passed the city gates, we've left the city behind us, and we're heading north up to the Halfling Hills to find Perrin Toscoppel and bring him back, or ostensibly. Now, yep, you got this group of these group of groupies hanging out with you. Andrin here on the left here is the one, the artist. He's been taking Unza's likeness and is interested on any other interesting things that can be painted along the way. And so describe your movement. I mean, there's six of you. And there's traffic on the road, wagons coming in, wagons coming out, that sort of thing. And along the sides of these roads here are like, farmlands and fields and such. So how do we proceed?
So, Khalil, are you playing us a nice tune?
We're jamming. We are not at all being stealthy or like taking care of ourselves or being nonchalant. We are just jigging away and having a good time, and I'm playing music and Orna's singing with me, and it's all great.
Okay. Well,
So, yeah.
yep, and
I'm trying to keep an eye out for obvious dangers, but I'm not really super intent on the passersby.
sure. All right. Well, you're making your way. You're playing, having a good time, singing. Shallan is singing with you. Unsa is just she doesn't know what to do, so she just kind of follows along and just pretend pre, you know just goes along with you.
Do
And
her feet shuffle or does she actually walk?
she walks, but
Okay.
as much as
I was
a
just
halfling,
wondering.
yeah, for a halfling, she walks good well for a halfling.
Okay. I'm
And
still convinced she's dead, so go ahead.
that's all right,
That's
yeah.
I was just wondering.
And then Andrin is following with y'all. He's not singing, he's like sketching as he walks. He's got like a pad and he's sketching as he walks. And you guys are moving up the road. And y'all go ahead and give me a perception roll.
Doogie, perception. Oh, thank God one of us is paying attention.
That's you. All right, let me take a look, quick look at something here. No, that's it. That's it. Right, I'm just gonna make a quick roll here, and roll something. I'm gonna add something to it. And okay, so Khalil,
Hey.
it's you
Yes.
as you're strumming along and singing. You're like I said, you're passing by like fields, right? And like you're passing by high wheat fields, and you notice though in those wheat fields, so there's a disturbance. You notice a disturbance here. You notice a disturbance on this side, and those disturbances in the wheats are moving towards you pretty quickly.
Okay, are there any other travelers about?
At this point, no, you don't see any in front of you or behind you. You're kind of on an isolated part of the road.
Okay. Guys, we have incoming to the right and the left of us in the wheat fields. Do we want to scurry along or do we want to let them, do we want to find out what the disturbance is?
Think we want to scurry.
Okay. Everyone,
I think we should
top
scurry.
speed, let's
Let's
go.
scurry. Top seed, let's go. Feline agility.
Okay.
Breaking it out.
You make it, you start hauling ass, and as you do, out of the sides of the wheat fields coming towards you on both sides, you see some of these.
Oh,
You see
dragon roosters? What the hell?
kind of. If you would like to make a and if we want, we can have this reposition, because like imagine Orna would be on the outside, protecting the flanks with Kilil there in the center. If you want to make, you can make an Arcana roll. I'd also say history would work. Arcana or history.
Okay. All right. I would like to roll. Let me check.
Can I make mine at advantage because I know
Roll.
what they are in real life?
No.
You know what the dragon chickens are? Ooh.
I clearly don't.
It's a dragon chicken, exactly.
Yes,
I didn't know
exactly.
you could get a zero. Wow, that's
Okay, Khalil.
funny.
Yes, you have heard of
Okay.
these. You have heard of the cockatrice, a small little, chicken-like creature that attacks, and its bite has a petrifying effect. A failed saving throw would start making you turn to stone. But there's no surprise, so y'all can go ahead and roll initiative. Oh, well, actually, hold on. Let me set the combat up first. Got to do that. Let me
Okay,
do this here.
I need to go to my character sheet
Well, hold on. I haven't.
and
Hold on. Not yet. Not yet.
inventory.
Got it. Give me a second. Oh, I may have just messed it up.
My short bow is not in my weapons inventory.
Short bow? All right, let me fix that.
Yeah. Okay. Because I would like to use a
And
ranged weapon.
I got the combat set, so now you can roll initiative.
Okay.
So let me so here. Let's see. Content items. Said short bow.
Ooh, I love being lucky.
Thank you.
Here we go, short bow. All right. I think you now have that on your inventory. You do?
I do, thank you, sir.
Uh-huh.
I would like to equip. Don't know how to do that. Dagger, we want to unequip. Short bow, we want to equip. Okay.
All right, so Khalil,
Okay.
when they burst out as you're moving down the road at a quickened pace, you see them in front of you, on the sides of the group, wanting to move in, but you get to go first. What do you want to do? And we're kind of at relative range here. This isn't to scale.
I want to scream like a little girl, and no. I'm going to attack this one. So let me target him. This guy. All
Okay.
right. I think I target. Did I target him?
Doesn't look like
Let me
it.
see.
Oh, yeah,
There we go.
yeah, so you're
There we
back.
go.
Yep.
Okay. Whoa.
Yep, that's
That hit.
a hit. Go ahead and roll that damage. Automatically applied like I could. Sweet. All right. So, yep, you shoot it with an arrow. Anything else you got?
Score.
Bonus
Now I would
action.
like to, I would like to duck behind. Actually, do I want to hide or do I want to? I want to hide. I'm gonna hide behind Jorts.
Move, shall we?
Yeah, I'm gonna use halfling nimbleness and get behind Jorts.
Okay. And don't bother rolling stealth unless I need you to. And
Okay.
we'll assume you're hiding. Anything else?
Nope.
All right, Orna.
Is gonna take out his scimitars, run up and do a slash at both.
All right.
Oh man, that was so close.
Not that one.
Right, try it again.
You got a plus five, so
Of course.
All right, so yeah, you overextend yourself and he gets a free peck at you.
Uh-oh.
Oh, he got you.
Oh.
And he's
He
gonna.
doesn't. Oh, so I see. So now he does a saving throw to see if he's
Starting to get petrified.
petrified.
Yeah, so you take three
Okay,
damage
I
and
understand.
yep, and give me a con save, please. Oh, wait a minute. I think. Oh, wait a minute. I attacked a cockatrice. I didn't attack you, Orna. But I still rolled a 21. Would that hit you? Yeah, I think that would
Yeah.
hit you. Okay, all right. So, yeah, give me your con save. DC 11. All right, well, you're not turned to stone just yet. What happens is you begin to turn to stone, you are restrained, and you do the saving throw again at the end of the next turn, and if you fail again, then you're petrified. So you are restrained. Anything else for you? Yeah, that was still yeah, it was your turn. That was a kind of a an opportunity attack.
I think I'm gonna let that be it. Yeah.
All right. Jorts, you get to finally smash something.
Hey, so I think I'm gonna go after this lower guy right here that's been eluding us. Target. I've got a I'm going to rage.
Right. I still love how that's just a screaming mouth.
And then I'm going to use my great axe and take a swing.
Hey, who?
Or this guy right here. I'm move over here.
Oh, yeah. Ooh.
God.
Ouch.
Dang.
Well, yeah, same thing kind of happens. You overextend that axe wing, it's gonna try to make a peck attack on you. And it hits you. I believe you're resistant to the damage. So that would be what, five? So that would be two damage for you, right? Let me just make sure. Is that right? Yeah, piercing damage. Okay. And then give me a con save. Oh, you are restrained as well. All right, anything else for you?
I don't think it can do anything else now that I'm restrained. All right.
All right. So now the NPCs are going to go at the end of the round. So it is now Cockatrice's turn. This one here is going to continue its pecking on you there, Jorts. And you are restrained, so we're going to get advantage on that. And it
Yay.
misses. Okay. So then this one is going to continue its peck attack on Orna. Again, restrained, so advantage. All right. You're going to take some pecking damage there. You're going to take four pecking damage.
Okay.
And this one, I'm going to do I'm just going to do a random check. Orna, you're odd. Jorts, you're even. Right, coming to Jorts. Oh, got it. Oh, wrong button. All right, so he's going to target you for a pecking at advantage. And it's like you're surrounded by these rabid chickens. All right, Jorts get hit for piercing damage. Oh, okay, well, only two, but you're resistant, so one. Okay, now that's their turns. NPCs. You see Andrin painting. Now you see Shallon run up here, and she is going to, let's see what she's gonna do. She's gonna see me make an unarmed strike. Let's see. Make an unarmed strike here.
I will beat you to death with my hands, you chicken dragons.
Yeah, she can do two of those. Okay, that's what she's gonna do. She's gonna target that and do unarmed strike. Hit it. Unarmed strike. Hit it twice. So let's do damage.
Ooh.
Hey.
And damage.
Hey.
Now, Unsa, you
Hello.
see her eyes kind of light up.
Oh God.
And you see, like, magic starting to charge her. And from her hands emerge a firebolt.
Hey.
Yeah.
I thought I hadn't targeted. Oh well.
I was about to say, I think you hit Unsa.
Targeted Unset. Well, 20 would still hit. That's all right. Damage on the firebolt is gonna do. Probably. Oh, I gotta give that back to Unset.
Oh man.
Only one. But all right, so let me take that away from him and give Unsa back the hit points. And let's see here. That was them. Okay, that was that. Okay. I'm going to reroll initiative for the cockatrices because they go last. Reroll initiative. And they go a little sooner. Khalil, you're still up. You go first. What are you going to do?
Okay. So I'm going to go over and beat the living hell out of the painter. No. All right. I'm going to target the one that Itza just tried to hit with the firebolt and go at it with my short bow again.
This one here?
Yeah, the one on the yep. right. Yeah, yeah that, one. That one.
Yeah, I see you targeted. Cool. That's a hit.
All right, and damage. I so wanted to be a six.
All right. That one's looking hurt. Looking like it's probably not
going to
last much longer.
Just looking hurt?
No, I mean hurt as in not going to last longer.
It's been hit so many times.
Anything else for you?
I'm going to step back behind Unsa. There we go. That's it. That's all I'm doing.
Cockatrice's turn. Now, this one here, the one that's hurt, is going to action disengage and start running away. It doesn't want anything to do with this. This one here is going to continue his attack on Orna. Pecking away. Oh, I forgot to do advantage, but that's all right. Let's roll again here. Forgot advantage.
Oh, man.
And it hits. All right, Orna, you're going to take 5. You still up?
Yep.
You still up. You're restrained and you're almost dead, but that's fine.
Not almost dead. I mean, yeah, this level up, I got
helped
hit points
a lot.
To spare now.
Hit points, okay. I'm ready. I got hit points. All right, looks like Jort's get hit too. For 1, you know, with your resistance. Yeah. And then it is Orna's turn. Now, let me take a quick look at something, Orna, before you move, before you do something. I just want to see you make a saving throw at the end of your turn. Okay. All right, so what do you want to do? You're restrained, can't move.
Yeah.
I think that puts you at disadvantage and such.
It does. And Orna can't really do much. So he's just going to try and kill these things before this petrification takes over.
Yeah, you feel it like starting on your legs and it's starting to work your way up. And if you make your next save, you get to fight it off.
Yeah, so I'm going to go for this one right next to me first. And we're going to hope that we hit. Oh boy. I forgot I was rolling with disadvantage. That's my bad. Okay. This next one, I will roll with disadvantage specifically. There we go.
Oh, what a shame.
That
blows. Nothing sucks worse than critting on a disadvantage.
Oof, I might as well. Let's use my action surge.
Action surge.
So I get to attack one more time. Hey!
Okay. There you go. All right, 7.
Yep, and then...
Wait, which one were you aiming at? The one on the top or the bottom?
The one up top. That's where I had my target, I think.
I didn't it didn't auto damage, so let me just fix that. Right, that's fixed. All right, you got anything else?
Nope.
All right, give me.
Orna just kind of goes into the coolest pose that he can. I'm just like, this is probably gonna be it.
All right, give me your con save.
Oof.
You are
Just so wanted to be an 18.
petrified. No longer restrained. You
How do
are.
you fix that?
Well, with the score, with the arcana you rolled, you would know it lasts for a limited time. It lasts for about 24 hours.
Oh, okay.
Is there a petrified thing in here? Let's see, petrified. I'm just gonna say frozen. You're frozen. Okay. All right. Now, that brings us to Jorts.
Jorts. Restrained Jorts. What can Jorts do? Can I reach this dude?
You can reach this guy here. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
Yeah, attack him.
And a disadvantage.
Yeah, I don't. Okay.
Yes.
Oh, got him. Not, oh.
Whoa.
Yeah, you like sliced a wing off. He's like, ah, rah, blood spurting everywhere.
I'm gonna hit him with a great axe again.
All right, go for it. Disadvantage.
Well, you can't hit with the great axe again. Yeah.
Oh yeah, you need two
Not
weapons, but
yet.
yeah, not yet, not yet. Okay. Anything else?
Can I claw him?
No, because you've got both hands on your
Yeah.
axe. Yeah.
Yep. Okay. I think I'm gonna call it good then.
All right, give me your con save.
Okay.
All right, you fight
Yay!
off the petrification. You are no longer restrained.
Excellent.
Now, NPCs. Jorna is going to come up here. Not Jorna. Why did I say Jorna? I don't even know who that is. Shallan is going to come up here and.
You said Jorts and Orna together.
Oh, I guess I did. All right, so she's going to unarmed strike.
Jorna.
Jorna. Unarmed strike. Where? Okay. Maybe I don't have you targeted. Target that thing. Okay, now we go. Unarmed strike. That's gonna be a hit.
She is little but mighty. Oh my goodness.
I was gonna say she's well on her way to becoming a monk.
Yeah, and she
Right?
she finishes that this one off.
Whoa.
Condition dead.
I told you to bring her along.
Right?
And then she's
Who knew?
gonna do her second unarmed strike. And hit
Yeah. Please.
for that much. And then Orna is gonna do the same thing. With her action, which is to firebolt.
You mean Unsa?
Unsa.
Yes, Unsa. Sorry. Okay, target. There we go. Spells, firebolt, and here we go. What's Unsa gonna do? Unsa's gonna hit.
That's how you spell Unsa.
Yeah.
All
I had
right.
a bunch of O's in front of it.
All right, so and the monks paint, or the rangers painting still. And then Jorts, you went last. I'm going to reroll your initiative. And okay, you move up the ladder a little bit. Khalil.
Okay, so I'm going to aim for the one next to Orna. Target. No, yeah. And I'm going to shoot the little bastard. Yes, I am. And I'm going to damage. Oh!
Ouch. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, it's... Yeah, another, you know, another wing cut off. Or, you know, fell off after the arrow tore through it.
Gross. Alright, I would like to... Orna, you're still doing good on your hit points, really?
I mean, yeah, I'm restrained. Or not restrained.
Well, I know, I mean, you're petrified, which means that if this chicken dude doesn't run off or just, like, fall over dead from blood loss, he's going to attack you again. So I was just wondering if you were good on hit points.
I don't think it'll attack me. I'm stone.
Yeah.
Oh, that's true. It would probably hurt itself if it attacked you. All right.
Sadly, it might be better to get behind yours.
That's what I'm thinking. I would like to move up and get between Jorts and the painter.
He'd on that right square. Here. Yeah.
Yeah, but that's Unsa, so.
Oh. I'm getting all my Unsas and Ornas and Jorts's mixed up.
Right. All right. No problem. All right. So there I am. Okay. All right. I'm good.
Right. Khalil, if you want, yeah. While you're there, you could just yell at our painter friend. just be like, hey, what's up with you, man?
You see his hands frantically working on this. Like, he's already erected up an easel, and he's, like, frantically going to town.
I'm just going to leave him alone until we finish this, and then I'm going to take his drawing and beat him over the head with it. All right.
All right, Jorts. You're no longer restrained.
No. I'm going to go after... Going after him.
No more disadvantage.
Oh, the wings are already ripped off. Just rip his head off, and then we'll have chicken for dinner.
Exactly. Let's go for it.
In the D&D cookbook, there is a recipe for cockatrice wings.
Oh, nice. Oh, yeah, there are. I didn't know. Okay.
That's a me, yes.
Yes.
Anything else?
Let me see. I can't hit him again?
No. Not yet.
Not yet.
Now, if you had a smaller weapon in each hand, then yes, you could take a bonus action to hit again. But with a two-handed weapon, you just get your one.
Got it. Okay. All right. Yeah, not sure that I can do anything else right now.
Okay.
So I think I'll stay.
We'll just let Shallon be decapitate him. It'll be fine.
Exactly.
Well, on its turn, it's had enough. It's going to disengage, and it's going to start running. And that brings us to our NPCs. Shallon declines to give chase, but Unsa is not happy that these little birds have threatened her friends, so she's going to take a shot at it. I do have someone targeted. Okay.
Ooh.
Hey.
And she finishes it off.
It's burnt chicken now.
Yep, yeah, hey. Now one did escape, but you do have right now the corpses of two cockatrices and a petrified fighter.
Awesome. George, you get to carry the petrified fighter.
All right.
I'm too little. I can't do anything.
Right.
Now, Andrin says, wait, wait, wait. And he runs up, grabs his easel, and runs up to where Orna is and flips over to a new parchment and starts, like, you know, sketching out Orna's cool pose. How did you pose, Orna, when you froze? How did you pose?
I think Orna posed just kind of like in a mid-swing so that it's kind of like an action pose. Like there's movement to it, even though he's stilled.
Okay.
That being said, when Orna gets out of this, he's gonna hate that he was painted.
I literally go punch this dude in the face.
You go punch him?
Yeah. Like, not even a joke. Like, I walk up and just punch him.
Target him. Give me an unarmed attack.
All right. Butthead. God. Moron.
I love it.
You just deserve to be hit. I missed with a 16?
Yeah,
he's not even paying attention to me, and I missed?
He sees you stomping up, and he's like, hey, what's up? And then, like, as you swing, he's like, whoa. He steps back. He's like, whoa, what's going on?
What in the absolute hell are you doing? We're in the middle of a fight with chicken dragons, and you're just painting?
That's why I came out here. I can't do both at the same time. I can't really paint if I'm fighting, and you seem to have it under control, and that's why I'm here.
We have a petrified fighter right now.
He'll be fine. Look at him. He looks super cool. He looks so cool right now.
I hate you. You are no help whatsoever. If you get eaten, I am not going to be upset about this.
I can handle my own, and I assumed you could as well. If I thought you were in danger, I would have put down my brushes and come to help.
You can't paint if you're not alive, dude.
Thank you so much.
I thought you seemed like you had it under control. There's only three of them. There were 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of you.
What exactly are you, like, contributing to this quest? This outing, this jaunt, this journey?
Can I punch him too?
If you would like, you can target him. Make an unarmed charm roll.
Yeah, George is raging. George is pissed.
Yeah. He's like, whoo, whoo, whoo. He's quick and agile. He's like, whoa, whoa, ladies, come on. This was the agreement. I was gonna come and draw and paint.
I understand that. I just thought you would be more useful in a fight. I mean, I understand there were three of them and five of us, but we ended up with a petrified fighter, and maybe we wouldn't have if you had done something more useful than painting or sketching. But
All right. Next time, I'll. All right. So, how about next time? If we get into a scuffle, I'll fight with you for a little bit, see if you're okay, and then if it seems okay, I'll ask you, hey, can I go paint now?
How about you take a mental picture and then paint it afterwards? Like, I mean, we've got the two dead chicken dragons. You know what they look like. You can continue to paint now.
Well, yeah, but while the action's happening, I have to get the outlines.
I hate you. All right, let's go. You're carrying the petrified fighter. Forget it.
Fine, yeah, I'll carry him. I don't care.
I think the more he talks, the more there's, like, a small shift in Orna's statue just the rage coming through. Just like a high pitched whine that is barely coming through, barely noticeable. Of him just internally screaming.
All right, well, he grabs some, like, you know, some wood and puts together this you know, very crappy looking sled, and like lays the petrified ornate on top of it and starts, "Oh man, this is heavy. Can I get some help here?"
"No, and I didn't say use a sled, I said carry."
"He's a statue. How am I going to carry a statue?"
"You're going to suck that it up on a cop and carry a statue."
"Yeah. Well, why don't we just camp here until he comes out of it?"
"In because front of the fire dragons. Chickens that you're refusing to fight? In front of those?"
They're dead.
"There could be more."
"There, yeah. We saw 3. There could be 20 in these woods."
Alright, he gives another tug, and I'm just not strong enough to move this guy."
"Oh god, George, would you please help him?"
"I'll help him."
"Well, between the two
of
you..."
"I'm going to fart at him the entire way."
"Well, between the two of you, yeah, you can lift up this statue and slowly make your way up the road. And you do so, you get past the scene, you make your way to, you know, a nice spot, sun's coming down, your movement speed has slowed, you know, dragging along a human life-size statue, yeah. So we'll say you make it up a little bit. You find a nice spot, you know, nice clearing. You can set up a little fire if you want and kind of relax.
All right, and we're gonna set up watches.
Yep. Yep.
So, Unsa, did you know that you could do that?"
She's like, "No."
"Okay. Fair. I didn't figure you did know, but do you know if you can do anything else?"
"I can try."
"Yeah, why don't you try? See if something else happens."
"Unsa, do you sleep?"
"Not in a while."
"Oh, good. Then you can stay up and keep watch. Exactly. We'll all get some shut eye." "Good thought, George."
Well, while the fire's burning and Unsa's watching, Andrin's got his easel out. He's painting the party as they camp, he's got like some outlines of a few things now. The fight with the cockatrice, Orna's petrified stance, and now the camp he's kind of sketching out. And the all of you, except Orna, I guess, can take a long rest.
Cool. Cool. I didn't really need to, but...
Nope.
Well, if you needed to. And then the next morning, you pack up, start hitting the road, and eventually, Orna reverts to flesh.
Yay!
"Oh, that sucks." "While I was in there."
"Oh, whoa, what just happened? I just poisoned
everyone." "No, I don't know."
"Oops, sorry." "Oh, did you poison her?" "I did not mean to do that."
"That was pretty awesome, though."
"Let me unpoison y'all."
I like how you poison the entire party at once. So.
Yeah, that is kind of a neat thing, now that I know I can do that. I was trying to unfreeze Orna here.
"Now,
you're unfrozen, but the whole party's poisoned."
Endrin, did you say that you wanted to ask in the middle of a battle if you could stop fighting to paint? Did I hear that right?"
Look, I've already had this conversation with Khalil, and that was the understanding that I'm the artist. And this is good for you because now you are gonna be famous. Like once I get these pictures put out, you're gonna get a cut of the proceeds, and it's gonna make you famous. So I don't see the problem here.
Are you famous?
Not yet.
I
But
think. Well, then
I will
why would
be.
Levi
Better
want to buy
question.
your paintings?
I think the better question would be for you to ask us if we want to be famous.
That doesn't ever everybody?
No.
Why
Well,
not?
I do.
Yeah, she sings so loudly that everything gets advantage on perception rolls. No, I'm just kidding. But okay, look, I guess there was a misunderstanding about my role in all this. I'll help out next time.
That's all we ask. You can paint
Yes.
us almost any time, other than when we're fighting.
All right,
And when we're
fine.
fighting, you do something other than paint.
You want to see what I got on you so far?
Yes.
All right, so let's see how good it looks. Oh, wrong one. It looks super cool. Like you're like amazed because like he's already got color filled in, and it looks like you're like like wow. It's pretty fucking amazing.
Orna wants to hate it so bad.
And even when he shows Khalil and George, are like, whoa.
Yeah. Okay. All right. I kind of want to take my request back, because you're really good. So, unless we're getting our butts kicked, you don't have to fight.
Are we all agreed on that? He's looking at you, Orna.
Is art really good, Orna?
Orna's gonna say, sure. And he's gonna reach out his hand to like shake his hand.
Okay, yeah, he goes to shake it.
When he shakes Orna's hand, Orna's gonna do a shocking grasp.
I just lost connection.
You're gonna hand buzz him
just to keep him on edge. An 18 misses.
18 doesn't hit.
Yeah, that misses. He like I don't I mean if you got him by the hand, take advantage on that. Go ahead and do
It
it, yeah.
doesn't matter. Can you even roll high enough to hit him?
I mean, maybe on a nat 20. Okay.
All
Oh,
right.
okay. There we go.
Now, yeah, you're shocking him, and he's like, "The hell, man!"
Don't get too cocky, but I'm keeping this painting.
Right, yeah, it's yours, man. It's like now, like kind of rub it, like shaking his hand. Damn.
Was a lot of damage for a hand buzzer.
That reminds me of that scene in the first Batman. Remember the Joker and his hand buzzer?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, is the hand buzzer thing. Yeah. Used to buy them in five and dimes and joke shops and such.
But not the lethal kind.
No.
No.
Yeah, those weren't over the counter.
You had to get them from special, super villain,
Yeah.
distributors.
You had to go to the Acme shop for one of those.
Acme. I remember that. That was funny. All right, so
Yeah.
we're hitting the road again, making your way up, and you're getting close to what's going to be getting dark soon, and you are getting close to Roscoe's house, and you know that's always a welcome spot for you to hang out in. Do we want to make our way there, keep on the road, camp on the road? What do y'all want to do?
Let's go to Roscoe's. Yay,
Yeah.
Roscoe.
Yay, Roscoe's.
All right, we're going to Roscoe's house. All right, so let me set something up here real quick. Like, let me move you all out of here. Players, here we are. Okay, so oops, sorry. All right, so we're gonna say Khalil's here. We're gonna say Jord's here. Orna, Indrin, Shallan, and Unsa. Right, so it's gonna be pretty well dark by the time you make it here. And before we start this, let's take a quick break, drinks and bathroom and food and such. I'm gonna pause this right now. All right, we're back on. Oh crap, hold on, what happened here? Oh, I know what happened. Let me fix this here. Okay. Now it's about nighttime when you reach Roscoe's house. And when you reach Roscoe's house, from inside the house, you can hear some yelling, screaming, crashing. Through the windows, you see flashes of magical light, and standing in front of the door, seem to be guarding the place, are three skeletons. Now they see you.
Skeleton.
Yep, you see them. They see you. Let me set up a new combat. One second here. All right, feel free to roll initiative.
Hey, painter dude, you remember what I said about not having to help? Yeah, a lot.
Okay.
Five, six, seven, and we all got nines. I love it. Oh, no wait. Orna did get a five.
Orna
No.
didn't roll yet.
Orna didn't roll.
Oh, wow. All
Ooh,
right.
Orna got an 18.
Yeah, Warner's going first. What do you want to do?
Yay.
Sorry, I was taking notes.
And everyone should be full rested by now.
All of us? Or
Yeah, you too.
okay.
Yeah, you had a chance too before we got here.
Okay. Then Orna will. I think he's just gonna run up. Let's see how far that
And we
is.
are two scale now.
Yeah, Orna's gonna run up to here. And then he's just gonna wail on the sky, 'cause that's the front door, right?
Yes.
And he's in right now? Okay. Ooh, yes. And then second attack on him as well.
Ooh, wow.
Yeah.
We're rolling. We're rolling.
Ah. Okay.
That was still 5 points.
He's almost dead again.
Cool. Then that'll be on this turn.
All right, Jorts.
Right, so I'm gonna move up to where this first dude is, first skeleton, right next to Orna. To Orna's left.
Go ahead.
All right.
just targeted yourself.
Yeah, I'm trying to move myself.
And the there you go.
Target him. I'm gonna go ahead and rage.
Yeah.
There you go.
Oof, this is a much better day than yesterday.
And there we go.
Yeah, he's not gonna last. He's not gonna survive another one of those. Anything else for you?
I don't think so. Unless I can do an unarmed strike or something.
Nah. Is this adding your rage damage?
She already did. When she clicked the damage, I saw it deduct that 2 off already.
Okay. Yeah. Then what's your strength score? Or what's your strength modifier? Because I feel like that should be higher.
It's +4 right now, raging. +2 normally.
Oh, okay. Okay, so then...
Yeah, that's right.
Did you roll a 4? Okay.
Yep. All right, Khalil? All
right. I'm going to... move up... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, no, 1, 3, 4, there we go, and then, yeah, I'm going to stay there, all right, and then I'm going to shoot, this dude, okay.
There's a
awesome.
Hit.
Awesome.
Splat.
Okay. And then I would like to give a No, I'm going to wait on that. Okay, I'm done.
All right. Now, skeleton's turns. All right. So, they're just going to kind of form up here on Orna since he's the closest. This one's going to target you with a short sword. And it's going to hit you.
Mm-hmm. Ooh. Ouch. I like that the animations are working.
Yay, I like the animation too. Mm-hmm. And this one, same thing. On you with his short sword.
Ow.
Gotcha. Ah, okay, now there's the other end of the spectrum. Just for 3.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. BC's. Let's see, how fast can Shalom move? She's got a speed of 30. She's going to go 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. She got anything range she can do? Oh, yeah, she got a short bow. She will target this guy. And miss him. She's like,
dang it.
And you see her, and you hear her say, damn it. Unsa moves up a little to target this guy with a firebolt. hitting it and likely finishing it off.
Kill him.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, this one's
Holy
it.
God.
This one's done. And Andrin's like, "Is it okay to paint?"
Yeah, shut up.
Maybe, yeah, I think so. I think you're good.
All right, he
Yeah.
starts pulling out his easels then. This last skeleton went last, so I'm gonna re-roll its initiative. And it's still not going first. Or no, you're still first. Oh,
Cool.
let me now since Jorts and Orna are closer to the house, you can hear a little more of the commotion going inside. You hear things being knocked over, you hear Roscoe's voice, "Get away from me! Get away from me!" And he's casting magic and you see light happening, and that's where you're at. All right, Orna, your turn.
Orno will shout out to Roscoe, or not Roscoe, to Endgame. There might be some more stuff going on inside, so we may need your help, but for now, you're good. That being said, everything's going on inside, so I don't know what you're going to do out here. and then Orno will reach out to touch this skeleton and hopefully hit with a shocking grasp. Queen.
That's a hit.
So it takes 5 damage,
Zap.
and the other part of Shocking Grasp is that it cannot take reactions, so Orna is going to run into the building.
Okay. All right,
And basically look for Roscoe. Yeah.
you see him right here. And you see what he's running from.
Oh.
Oh.
Light? Demon light?
let's see, Orna, if you want, since you're the first to see, if you want to do, I'll say Arcana, History, or Religion in this case.
Okay.
You can pick one.
You're doing Arcana.
Yeah, looks like a ghost.
I'm sorry, no, history. That's what it was.
Okay, so you've taken your action, you've run in there. Anything else for you?
Yeah, hold on. How much speed was that? That's 15. Will do. About 30, 35. So I can get here. Can I try and hit him or hit it, or is it too far?
Do you still have
Like with the wall there. I can action surge
Yeah, you can reach him.
if need
You can
be.
reach him.
Cool. Then I will action surge. To attempt to hit this ghost thing, that's probably not going to do much because
Oh,
my
wow.
swords
Wow.
are regular, though. That
I thought it was gonna go right through it, so I'm impressed you hit it at all. Good job.
Well, that's what happened. Your sword did go through it, and it doesn't really feel like you did a lot of damage, but maybe you did some, like it's resistant. And then anything else
Bonus
Oh, yeah.
action. I will use my second wind to regain 1d10 plus 2 hit points. All right, and that's my turn.
All right. Now I'm going to put the Spectre on the initiative at the end of the turn. This skeleton gets to go next. So having Orner ran off into the thing, he's going to commit you
Yep.
there, Jorts, with his sword. And he's gonna hit you. For six. And it's your turn.
I'm gonna hit him back. Ah, painful.
Else? Bonus actions, anything?
Do I have any of those?
I don't know, do you? Probably not. I don't see
No, I do
anything here.
not.
Okay. Then we're on Cleo.
Let's see. I would. Right, I'm gonna shoot that dude. Shoot. I'm gonna target. I'm gonna target him. And shoot him. There we go. I am going to miss completely. All right. Is there a back door to this place or a window or any other entrance way other than the front door?
Well, there's windows here and here.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, and
Then
but
I'm
there's no
gonna
back door.
mosey. I'm going to.
We're gonna sneak through a window and I'll take care of this dude.
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. All right, there we go.
Perfect.
Check something here real quick. Same thing. Okay. All right. So, Cleo, you went last. Let me re-roll your initiative. See if you get a better spot. Okay. Yeah, you're gonna go second. All right. Orna, you're first. Yep.
Oh, we all went.
Oh, I forgot the NPCs. Hold on. I forgot the NPCs. Okay. Let's see. Let's see this. Shallon comes up, targets the skeleton.
That skeleton's just about to get a beat down.
Right,
Gonna
there's
be
a
a
hit.
pile of bones.
And then,
Shallon, the only one who could
wow.
hit him.
Damn. Okay, yeah.
Right.
Well, that's fine. It's now dead. All right, so Unso will then move up her. Let's see, she's gonna go 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. And Andrin is gonna carry his stuff. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. And then now, it's a new round. Orna, you can go.
Orna will yell out, "There's like a ghost or something in here." And then he's just gonna attack.
Oh.
You're having a rough time with those, huh?
Wow.
Yeah, so that ghost don't take kindly to being attacked.
Oof.
But it looks like it's not going to do anything
Oof.
about it.
Oh,
Anything
take my
else?
second attack.
All right, go for it.
Bonus action attack.
Yeah.
Yay!
Yeah.
cool. I like how it auto does the resistance. I like that. Cool. All right. Anything else?
I yell out. I could probably do with some like magic damage in here.
Okay.
We're coming. Hold your horses.
Now, Orna, we can say you can make it through the window for half your movement. It's like, well, this will be difficult terrain to get through the window. So that, to get like to here would cost you 10 feet.
Okay.
No, hold on. No, no. To get here would be 20 feet.
Okay. And then I only have 5 more feet of movement then. Yep.
And you
so.
See, and you see him on top of the table getting ready to cast a spell. You see Orna here fighting this ghost.
Okay.
You can still take an action from there. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna see if I can target the ghost from there. And I can. Okie dokie.
A 1 would not be good for Orna.
But you re-roll ones, oh, so
that's right.
I don't have any ones.
All right, you hit it.
I hit it. I hit it. I'm gonna damage it.
All right. Some of its essence floats away.
All right. That's it. That's hold on. I'm going to give Orna some bardic inspiration.
Love that.
There we go. Have a bardic inspiration. Your rolls have been critting lately, so I want you to be able to fix that.
All right, so it's the ghost churn, and it's going to lash out at you there, Orna. Okay. And then it looks like gotcha.
Yeah.
And so what does this do? Here, let's take a quick look. Let's see. You're going to take some damage, and then you must succeed on the saving throw, or your max hit point maximum is reduced.
All right. What?
Yep. Give me. Here's the damage. You're gonna take this damage here, as it pulls your warmth out of your body. To
oh my god!
It's evil.
Ow.
And then give me a con save.
Okay.
I'm so glad I gave you inspiration.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Does that. Past.
It does. Yep.
Yes.
You need to take.
Okay.
Yeah. So you feel like the warmth of your body leaving you and like fueling this this undead thing, and then it's George's turn.
All right. Let's see. So I'm gonna head towards this ghost over here.
All right.
Head inside.
Yeah, that's just normal movement. Doors open.
Yeah. See how close I can get.
Oh.
Will it allow me? Target.
What's your speed?
Yeah, what is your speed?
Yeah. That's a good question. Feline agility?
Yeah, that'll get you there. That's a bonus action. So yeah, you can do that.
Yeah. Okay. Right.
Let me clear this out. All right.
I'm gonna go ahead and use it so that
There you go.
It counts it as gone. Alright. No. Now I can go ahead and attack him.
You can?
Yeah.
Interesting, it's not showing the great axe.
Because you've already got it up.
Oh, okay. I wonder if I can take it down or get rid of it somehow.
Are you targeting him?
Yeah.
Yeah, hit it again.
Oh, here we go.
Okay,
I got it.
Good.
Yeah,
All
it
right.
just took us.
Yeah, good. Ooh, we got him. Okay.
Yes, it hit. Good job.
Yay.
All right.
That could have been better, but five is better than nothing. That's
yes.
awesome.
All right, let's see what the other your friends are doing. Here, let me take a quick look at something here. Wrong button. All right, so Roscoe is going to try to ray of frost it. Animation for that.
This modifier is a plus six.
All right, that hits. All right, and then other NPCs, Unsa is going to run in 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and I think she can get a clear shot. She'll hold her action there. And then Shallon, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Same thing. And then Andrin brings in his kit and his painting. Right. So, Jorts, you went last. I'm going to reroll for you, your initiative. And now you still go last. Orna, you're first.
Orna's going to put away one of his swords, reach out, and do a Shock'em Grasp. Orna will use that Bardic Inspiration to try and hit.
Okay.
That probably still doesn't hit
a
at a nine.
No, it doesn't hit.
Dang it.
Anything else?
I don't think I have any more bonus actions. Yeah, I'm done.
Khalil?
I want to climb up on the table next to Roscoe so I have a better line of shot. And, oh, I also want to make an Arcana roll to see if I know what this thing is.
Go ahead.
But I'll do it after I attack. I hit. Oh, yeah. Okie dokie. Oh, yeah.
Nice. Slowly withering it away.
Nope.
Yeah.
I was hoping that.
Some form of incorporeal undead.
Okay. That's very specific. Thank you.
All right, its turn. Still concentrating on Orna here. It likes the taste of life warmth it got from it earlier, from Orna earlier. So let's see if we can get some more. And looks like we miss. Okay.
Oh, no.
Yay.
Jorts.
Well, I'm gonna do the only thing that Jorts knows how to do, which is smash this thing.
Smash away.
Yay!
All right. Let's see. Unsa is going to move up a little further to get a good angle. We got three halflings kind of hanging out right here in this corner of the house.
Halfling corner.
Halfling corner. That's right. That's a hit. Okay.
All right, still up. And then, now Shallon comes up, and she's like, "Whoa, what the hell is that? Maybe y'all can handle that." And then Andrin's still painting. And George spent less. Let me re-roll her initiative. Oh, she bumps up some. All right, Orna, you're next. You're first.
I like to think that George just accepts all pronouns.
Yeah, exactly. Because we've been saying... Exactly. No, George doesn't care.
You know what? Shocking Grasp didn't really do what I wanted it to.
Only because you missed.
Yeah. But that's the spell's fault, not mine.
Oh, okay, yeah, yeah.
We'll give it one more chance.
Yeah.
It's the spell's fault.
It's the spell's fault, absolutely. Yeah, I hear that. Anything else for you?
That's all I can do.
Jorts.
All right. I'm going to do the one thing, my one trick.
You hear smashing.
All right. It's going, it's still up, but not much longer. Khalil?
So, I will shoot it. Oh, yes. That was so close. All right.
All right. The specter shrieks as its incorporeal essence fades into nothingness.
Hey, Roscoe, so where the hell did that come from?
He just kind of, like, plops down on his table, like, you know, he's taking the Tom Brady pose, and he's like, oh, man, where do you think they came from? It was Perrin probably sent them.
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Yeah, what do you mean you don't know? And who's this? He's pointing to Unsa.
We found her in the woods.
Yeah, she's our new buddy.
Oh, is she okay?
We're not sure. I think she's dead. But she can shoot fire out of her hands, so we keep her around.
Yeah, that's pretty helpful skill, yeah.
Yeah. So, we're actually here to, well, first of all, to crash on your couch.
Sure.
But second of all, we're going to go collect Perrin tomorrow.
We mean collect.
Well, this dragonborn in the city wants us to get this guy named Shamash wants us to get Perrin and bring him to the city.
Wait, what happened
to the dock?
Oh, okay.
Well, I figure while Perrin's away, you can go try to sweet talk your wife and get her and the kid back.
Yeah. I could do that. Okay.
Yeah. So you should go with us, and we'll and you hide, and we'll get Perrin to leave, and then you could sneak in and talk to your wife.
I'll work something up. Yeah, we could definitely do that. Yeah.
Okay. Cool. All right. But yeah, in the meantime, these are all of our, NPCs that we found, and this guy just paints. He's somehow very tough, but useless.
He has waves and Shallon, smiles.
Have you met Shallon before?
Nope.
Okay, she is awesome. She is mighty, and brutal.
That's right.
And then we have Unsa, who is dead. But she also is awesome because she can shoot fire out of her hands. So, and we're trying to find out what happened to her, actually. She has a retrograde amnesia, and we cannot figure out what is who she is or where she came from or anything. It's like she just appeared.
Well, if it helps, we can go back a little bit, because remember when y'all were questioning people and someone described what that Rethal character?
Yeah, so we know that, or we've put together that he probably killed her, and then something about him or what he used to kill her probably made her undead somehow.
Right, but we still don't know where she came from, though. I mean, like, we know he killed her, but we don't know why or, like, who she is.
Right.
So he points to her.
I'm going to describe the guy that we know, or that we are pretty sure killed her, to Roscoe and see if he knows who that is, too.
Yeah, that's Perrin's muscle man.
Yeah. So, yeah, but we don't know who she is or why, or like why they wanted her dead.
Well, you're going to go see Perrin, right?
Yes.
He'll likely, and Rethal will likely be there.
Maybe we shouldn't take Unsa with us. I don't know if they'd be happy to see the non-dead person they tried to kill.
So we're thinking Unsa's just gonna hang here at Bosco's house and just...
Or we could just show up with Unsa and see what Perrin and Muscle Man do.
Hey, how y'all doing? This is our friend Unsa.
Yeah, hey, what's up? We brought this dead chick with us. You recognize her?
I mean, that was my
plan. A little shock and awe?
Yeah, that was not necessarily the shock and awe part of it, but yeah, I fully knew that. You know, it was probably Rethal that killed her, so this might bring up something, but I just kind of was going to roll with it. Because, hey, maybe it does stop them for a half a second from killing us.
Gives them that second of pause that you need.
Yep.
They're not going to kill us. We're just going to get Perrin to come back with us to meet with Shamash. Like, well, there's no reason for Perrin to kill us.
Yeah, that's the plan right now. But once we start talking to him, you think Perrin's not going to piss me off?
Okay, maybe you and Unsa should stay here. And me and Jorts and Shallon will go. And Roscoe can go with us and hide and sneak in. And we'll... Oh, yeah, and then we'll collect you on the way back. And Perrin will already be on his way. And then we can confront him with the dead girl. With Unsa.
That sounds boring. I'm not doing that.
Okay, fine.
That's the line of the day, right, though. You think he's not going to piss me off?
Yeah. All right, let's go get our asses kicked by Rethal or whatever. And... Yeah.
All right. Before we go, Roscoe, I simply must raid your cabinets for any alcohol you have if I'm going to travel with all of you.
Oh, wait,
well,
so
I'm
gonna
go to
going?
Sleep.
He says, I'm going too.
Yeah, you're gonna go, and when we get Perrin, and you're gonna sneak in. Yeah.
Okay. Well, yeah, he pulls out a couple cases of they've got some really some bottles of wine, and he starts opening them up and passing them out, and he fires up the stove and throws gets some stew going. And not before long, the whole house is smelling of beef and beer and probably some smoke of some kind. And y'all hang out, discuss what you're going to do, and y'all can long rest it if you need to.
when I have a moment with just the main crew, Orno will sort of reiterate what he said before we left, and just like, hey, there's a bunch of undead happenings going on. So just again, keep your eye out on Unsa just in case she is a spy for Perrin and somehow found us.
Oh, yeah. I don't think she's a spy for Perrin, though.
Well, that's kind of what a spy is supposed to do. It's make you believe that they're not a spy.
Yeah, I just. She's just, I don't know, not all there.
Yeah, playing dumb is easy. You just don't answer questions and say you don't know things.
That is true. All right, we'll keep it in mind.
All right.
That's all I ask. Right, let me take a quick look at something here. All right, so you're making your way up. You've passed come on, what's going on here? Why can't I just select you guys? There we go. Okay.
I like how there's still blood left from the chicken dragon.
Yeah.
You continue to make your way up, getting into the hilly areas, the hilly, more forested areas near where that air near where the bandit hideout was that you all saw a while ago, if you probably about a week or so ago by now. And
Right.
you keep making your way. Come on. There we go. Upward here. And take a quick look. Right, and as you're making your way up, everyone give me a perception roll.
Oh, look at there. Oh, dang it.
We get a 10, 7, 13. Okay, that's good. Let me take a quick look at something here. I just had you selected. That doesn't really count.
Right.
Okay, so that's going to be all right, George. So you'll be the first to spot it. Now, as you're making, and now we're not to scale or anything, but as you're making your way
Right.
through and around these hills, George, you notice movement in one of the hills as if something were up there, but like ducked for cover real quick as you were coming around, but something in one of these hills, let's say around here, is in a good position to watch and see where you guys are moving to.
Well, I'm pretty stealthy. Can I go explore?
You can, yeah. You're gonna let everyone know what's going on.
Guys, something just dug behind these he hills up here. I'm gonna go check it out.
Okie dokie, we're gonna pretend like, wait, nothing's going on and keep going, but at a slower pace so we don't leave you behind.
Sounds good. All right.
All right, so you
Go check
break
this out.
off and you're. Oh, I didn't mean to target anyone. Sorry. You break off and there you go. And go ahead and give me
You
a.
break off and a sniper rifle comes out.
give me a stealth roll.
Okay. Oh.
Okay. Now, you make your way around the bend, up the side of the hill, and get a peek at what's back there. But unfortunately, when you spot them, they also spot you. And you do see a trio of hyena-like
Oh, son of a
humanoids.
bitch.
Oh.
Oh no, I'm hauling. Feline
Yeah,
agility.
run away,
Air.
run
I'm running
away.
away.
You're gonna run, you're gonna start running.
Yeah, I'm running.
Okay. Now, go ahead and
Go,
just you, George. Give
go.
me an initiative roll, George, just you.
Why won't it let me roll
Oh,
initiative?
let me clear this out here. And
Okay.
add him and add you. Now you should be able to. All right, well, on your way as you run, some javelins come your way. Oh, no, not javelins,
Oh.
arrows come your way. Just one arrow.
Zigzag.
Right.
But it misses you. Oh, wait a minute. Who did I target? Oh, it was a five. It would miss anyway. Okay. And you can safely make your hauling ass back to the party, and you think they're following.
Guys, I bought presents. Sorry.
God, what is it?
It's a bunch of gnolls.
Okay, do I know what that is?
At this point, yeah. Just savage, feline humanoids that worship, flesh-eating gods of war.
Oh, are they friends of yours,
Did
George?
I say feline? I meant jackal-like. They're not feline. They're jackal.
Right, yeah. They're
They're like
canine.
dogs. Okay.
About how many?
Three.
Three.
Do we want to fight or do we want to run? Are they in our path?
They look well armed.
No, they don't. They're not in your path. You can circumvent them if you want to try to run. You don't have to.
Let's try to run.
Okay.
So we're gonna
I'm
say.
down with trying to run. I have little tiny legs, though. Half our party has the little tiny legs.
Oh, that's true. Oh, yeah, there's too many of y'all that only have
Well, you do have a head
25
start.
feet of movement.
Well, you do have a head start, and you do have like hills and things to that you can use. So, if y'all want, if
Yeah.
y'all are gonna try to run, the three of you give me a survival roll. We'll see if you can, escape their track.
Oh.
We're gonna get eaten by jackals.
Shorts.
Oh, get a survival.
All right, it doesn't look like they're gonna gain on you, but it does look like they're still on the trail. But it doesn't look like they can overtake you. You've gotten a good enough head start, you're familiar enough with these hills, but they are tracking you. They're just not gonna overtake you. What do y'all wanna do about that?
Are they
Born
gonna give
a
up eventually?
I don't know, maybe.
Probably not.
All right,
Born
let's
a
ambush them.
That is far too late.
Yes.
Orna will take longbow and start firing.
So you're gonna find a position, get your longbow, and so are we taking positions to attack them as they make their way towards you?
Yeah, just kind of as I'm running. Since I got a nat one on survival, I'll say that I'm in the back of our pack, and so yeah, I'll take advantage of that and just kind of take out my longbow and
I
fire
think we have
on
time to
whoever's
hide,
there.
guys.
Well, maybe not
Don't think
time.
you have to like run and shoot at the same time. I think we have time to take positions.
Well, I
Well,
have 35 feet of movement, so
but we're not
I'm.
to scale.
I know, but like I'm still like
Well, if
because y'all
we.
have like slower speeds of movement, it's like it's faster for me to shoot every once in a while. And then, dash towards y'all as y'all dash away. I can catch up faster, is what I'm trying to say. Just so that they're the gnolls are a bit deterred from chasing.
Now, just as an option, so you're aware of all the whole situation. If you all did stand, you couldn't like set up an ambush or anything. You wouldn't like get surprise on them. But as they're approaching, you would each get like I would give you a free like ranged action before we started initiative, because you are able to set up and kind of find and see where they're coming from. I'd give you one free ranged action before we went into initiative. And then they would try to close the distance. If you want to keep running, if you want to keep moving, you can. Orna can keep in the back, and we can do a couple rolls to see how well he shoots. They're probably going to shoot back, and we'll see if that determines if they want to keep pursuing you or not. So you can choose either of those, really.
I don't think I have any ranged weapons.
Are we gonna try to run away or try to shoot them? I don't care either way.
I vote run.
Okay, let's run then.
All right, so
What do
Orna,
you think?
it's up to y'all.
Orna? Yeah.
I mean, yeah, Orna's still gonna shoot at least every once in a while.
Okay,
He's gonna
sounds good.
shoot
All right,
and then
so we're gonna
dash and
run
shoot
and
and then
you're gonna stay
dash.
in the back and shoot. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, so Orna, go ahead and give me a couple bow attacks. Just target one and just, roll a couple times.
Okay.
Just want to see how well you're shooting, how well they're shooting, to see what they want to do about that. So there's a hit. Roll again. It's a hit. No damage, just rolled a hit.
Oh, really good. Okay.
Yeah. And give me three rolls. Give me three attack rolls. So we got a hit, and one more. So th three
Well
hits.
done.
Okay. Now I'm just going to have one of them make a couple rolls. Let's see here. Let's do their longbow. Oh, why am I targeting Jorts? I don't know. Does a 21 hit you, Orna? I guess it does, yeah.
Yeah, it would.
Okay. Does an 11 hit you?
And 11 would not. It would not.
Okay, let's do one more. Okay.
Yeah, that hits.
Well, so you're hitting them 3 out of 3 times. They're hitting you 2 out of 3 times. And every time you hit them, you dash away. I mean, you didn't kill any of them, but like you stuck a couple of them. Maybe one of them stuck you for a few point, for some minor points that you can heal later. And then, yeah, they decide to break off the attack. It's not worth pursuing it because they can't seem to get an edge on you, so they're gonna go w look for more helpless victims. So they are no longer a threat.
Yay.
Well done.
Yay.
Yay.
And you continue making your way through the hills
Woohoo.
with no gnolls bothering you.
I'm gonna sing a song about how we ran away from Knowles.
The glorious retreat.
Yeah, the glorious retreat of the party.
Now, Andrew, and he does look a little despondent. He's like, you know how awesome that scene would be? I can just imagine in my head. That would be such an awesome scene.
Well, then you could use your imagination to paint it.
Yeah, and during those who do not fight do not get to determine when we fight.
Fine, fine. Just saying. Y'all missed a good opportunity. Now, eventually, you make your way. You continue down through the hills, through the paths and the trails and the trade routes, you probably have to find another spot, or maybe to hang out in this town, Bryden, for the night,
Yeah.
to rest up and such. But you can do that if you need to full rest. You can also spend money here in Viarden if you'd like. Anything in the player's handbook if you want to stock up on stuff, you can. And yeah, that's where we'll wrap up.
Right.
All right.
We should get some potions. Like some health potions.
Yes.
Yeah.
Are those 50 gold, I think? Yeah, a potion of healing. Yeah, you can. There's enough of those here. You can. Yeah, a lot of halflings here who like to cook up potions. You can find some.
Okay, we've got, hold on a second. Notes. D&D. Right. Oh, we got Shallon. What the hell? I'm looking to see how much gold we have. I forgot.
All right,
Hey, Shallon?
she buys each of you
We
a
got
potion of healing.
a. Okay,
Yay.
cool.
Yay.
Then George and Khalil have three potions each, and Orna has two.
Nice.
Nice.
Yeah. So we have five total together with us.
You
I
find
do.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have two.
Yeah, you have two. You had one before that you hadn't used.
I have here that I already have two. This would be my third.
Oh, that would be your third? Okay.
Think so. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Then we have six between us all. No, we have nine. Because George and I each have three, and you have three, so we have nine.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, cool.
And you're not gonna be too much.
And we still have a magic missile to use.
Oh, the scroll? Yeah, you got a scroll.
Yeah, the scroll.
Cool. And you're not too much further from Perrin's little estate.
Okay.
All right, cool. So let me go ahead and end this.